You are watching Age Buddy channel, online sewing tutorials and all things sewing. In this video I want to talk about a seam guide, why you need one or a few actually, how to use it correctly, what types of seam guides exist and how you can make it yourself. I'm using different kinds of seam guides all the time. That's how I can sew my clothes fast. And my dresses and skirts never ever have wavy stitching lines. The stitching is always straight and I can do it very easy and effortless. Let me show you my favorite tools that help to sew straight and save lots of time and frustration. Seam guide attachment from the sewing machine accessories. Magnetic seam guide. 6-in-1 stick and stitch guide with Nancy Zieman. Laser seam guide, DIY seam guides. In my sewing machine manual, this seam guide is called quilting bar, but I guess there are other names for this tool. I was surprised to find this small metal bar among my sewing machine accessories and had to read the manual to see how to use this thing. But it was a long time ago, and since then I have been using it quite often. It's really easy to install. Find a small opening on the foot holder. Insert quilting bar into the opening and slide the bar to set the width of the seams you want. My seam guide from the sewing machine accessories extends to a maximum width of around 2 inches, but there are longer seam guides available. For this seam guide to work, you will need to find some stitching lines that are already on the fabric, or you can use the edge of the fabric as the first line. Let me show you how it works at the different angle. Sew while tracing the previous seam with the quilting bar. You can see that the stitching lines are perfectly straight and the seam allowances are equal. This seam guide is really good for sewing decorative stitches that don't run wavy or crooked. Thank you. The magnetic seam guide is designed for smooth stitching at different distances from the fabric edge. With this device, it's easy to control the widths of the allowances when sewing on a sewing machine. This is how it looks. There is a strong magnet under the metal case. Let me show you how to use it. Place the magnetic seam guide directly to the throat plate, parallel to the presser foot, at a distance that depends on the desired width of seam allowances. For this, you can use markings on a sewing machine. Set the fabric so that the edge adjoins the magnetic guide. During sewing, run the edge of the fabric exactly along the magnetic seam guide, and you can sew without fear that your stitching lines are not going to be straight. As a result, the seam allowances are perfectly even. The magnet is very strong. It doesn't move when sewing, even with hard, heavyweight fabrics, and adjusts to any position on the metal throat plate of a sewing machine. The big plus of this magnetic seam guide is that it can be used with almost any presser foot. For example, I use walking foot for quilts very often, and the seam guide is perfect for sewing straight with the walking foot. I can top stitch leather using special presser feet for leather. Some sources say that it's not recommended for computerized sewing machines because it's magnetic. But I can assure you it can be used with modern computerized sewing machines only if you place it correctly. You can put it only on the metal throat plate of a sewing machine, but don't put it anywhere else. Then the magnet can destroy a computer inside the machine. But there is no computer under the throat plate, so this place is safe. Hey, are you tired to watch the video? Do you see these buttons under the video? If you subscribe to my channel or tap the like button, you can watch the video later when you have time. And also you will be notified when I publish a new video. The next seam guide is called 6-in-1 Stick and Stitch Guide with Nancy Zieman. If you don't want to try the magnetic seam guide, then you can buy plastic one. That's how it looks like. It has two plastic pieces and a small square ruler with grid lines and small holes for a needle. Let's see how to use this seam guide. For example, I need to make my seam allowances 5/8 of an inch or 1.5 centimeters. Place the ruler on the throat plate and align the needle with the desired grid line. Insert the needle into the hole and stick plastic pieces along the ruler edge. For this, you will need to peel the film from the bottom of each guide to uncover the sticky side. Also, before placing the guides, wipe away dust from the machine. During sewing, run the edge of the fabric exactly along the seam guide, and you will get perfectly straight stitching line. But I don't need to use the template always. If I need to make very wide seam allowances, I just put the seam guide at the distance I want. But these seam guides have to be placed exactly parallel to the presser foot, so I make some marks on my sewing machine for easy placement. Why is this guide called 6-in-1? Let's see. The first is for straight stitching. You just saw how it's done. Second, you can easily stitch strips of fabric together. Look, you put the guides like this, for example, one to the right at 1/4 inch seam allowances and the other one to the left at the width of the strips. And just stitch. Third, you can stitch outer curves. For this, you will have to place the narrow edge of the guide like this, with curve up. Let's see how it's going. Okay, done. The seam allowances are perfect. Fourth, you can easily stitch inner curves also. For this, place the narrow edge of the guide with curve down. Thank you. Fifth, you can use the guide for top stitching close to the edges or making quarter of an inch seam allowances, for example, which is not very easy with throat plate markings. Place the guide like this. Place the shaped edge on the side of the presser foot. The shaped edge accommodates the foot and you can easily stitch quite close to the fabric edge. For top stitching, I like to use special presser feet, and I wrote about them in my other tutorial, How to Sew Straight. Six. I guess the sixth thing is this plastic ruler with grid lines. As you can see, this simple gadget is pretty cool. The only thing that bothers me is the sticky side of the seam guide. But they say if the sticky side becomes weak, it can be restored by soaking in water with dishwashing liquid. Modern high-tech sewing machines can have a laser as a seam guide. I have such a fancy machine. Let me show you how it's done. I have a button on the sewing machine. I press it and I have the laser. You can see this red line on top of the fabric. This line always stays in front of the needle while you are sewing and shows where you have to stitch. The light is bright enough so you can see it on any fabric. I can adjust the sewing position by moving the laser to the left or to the right. The laser seam guide really helps to sew straight lines without making marks. Usually, it's better to align the laser with some previous straight stitched lines. This laser seam guide is very useful for quilting. Let me show you how to stitch half square triangles very fast using the laser guide. I'm going to use my quarter inch seam allowances presser foot. I line up the laser with the opposite corners of my squares, and after that I align the right side of the presser foot with the laser line. I stitch, guiding the fabric so that the corner of the square stays in line with the laser. Now I sew the opposite side of the square. Okay, done. Now I just have to cut between the stitching lines using my rotary cutter. And I have two pieces like this. Laser can help to sew zippers. Just align the laser with the zipper tape and stitch. I have used sticky notes, not one by one, but while they are still all together. Each note has a strip of glue on its back and can be temporarily attached to the machine. This small pad of notes is thick enough so the fabric edge can move along without slipping. But still it can slip sometimes with heavier fabrics. So you have to watch out for that. I heard you can use a painter's tape. Just stick a piece on your machine parallel to the throat plate. But the tape is thin, so you have to be very attentive not to go off the stitching line. The tape doesn't leave any residue on the machine, which is good. Some people advise to use a piece of elastic with sewn together edges. It works about the same as the painter's tape.